Hello, my dear children. Today we are going to learn a new story. It is very interesting and it is full of wonders, and it is visiting a new place or a fabulous, beautiful place in our imagination. I know you are familiar with the chapter. Familiar in the sense you will be knowing which chapter I am going to teach today. You're right, I am going to take Alice in Wonderland. So, we all like to imagine flying that, flying there, going to a beautiful place, getting a house that you have seen in the stories or in animated movies, to have a castle. All the boys would like to fight like a brave knight, drive a car, and you people all imagine very well. If it is a girl, girls like to imagine being a princess or being a queen and being a butterfly, birds or many other things. You like to imagine, or you want to visit places and you imagine things. So in this story also there is an imagination, that is the girl is going to a wonderland and the girl's name is Alice. So is the story's name Alice in Wonderland. So please take out your literature textbook and turn to page number 67. So we will know more about the author. The author's name is Charles Lutwidge Dodgson. The author's name is Charles Lutwidge Dodgson. He was born on 27th January in the year 1832. His pen name is Lewis Carroll. In the textbook it is written Lewis Carroll, but his real name is Charles Lutwidge Dodgson. Pen name means most of the authors do not like to reveal their real name, so they use a pen name. Pen name means the name that they use to write as an author's name when their work is done. So it is Lewis Carroll. He is a mathematician, photographer and inventor. You can see the picture here. You can see the picture here where I guess he is holding a photograph machine, that is camera, or it could be a lens also. So that is the picture of Charles Lutwidge Dodgson. His famous works are Alice in Wonderland and also its sequel, Through the Looking Glass. He has also written poem. And the famous poems are Jabberwocky, The Hunting of the Snark. He died on 14th January in the year 1898. So that's about the author. Now we shall start the chapter. So please be ready with page number 67. Alice in Wonderland. I'm going to read, please point your finger when I'm reading. Alice in Wonderland. One day, Alice was lying under a tree, listening to her sister reading a story. Suddenly, she saw a white rabbit scamper by. He had pink eyes and was wearing a blue coat. He took out a big watch from his waistcoat pocket, and as he hurried away, he said, "Oh dear, I will be too late." So you can see the picture of the rabbit as well as Alice on that particular page. You can see the rabbit has pink eyes, it is wearing a blue waistcoat, and it also has a big watch that he had taken from his waistcoat pocket. Yes, we'll continue. She thought there was something very different about this rabbit. It could talk. It wore a red waistcoat and it carried a watch. Alice wondered, "A talking rabbit? Rabbit who wears a waistcoat?" Alice was burning with curiosity and she followed the white rabbit. So Alice is the character's name in this story. So she was lying under a tree listening to her sister reading a story. And meanwhile she was listening to the story, she heard a voice So, a white rabbit moving around, and it had pink eyes and it had It was wearing a blue coat and it also had a big watch in his hand. And as he was hurrying, it was murmuring to itself that telling that I will be late. So she felt something is wrong, something is different or something is strange with the rabbit. She was wondering, it can talk and it is talking. Can you believe it? So she followed the rabbit. The rabbit started running and Alice followed the rabbit. The rabbit suddenly popped down a large rabbit hole. Alice jumped into the rabbit hole too. The rabbit went down and down and down and down into the rabbit hole. So the rabbit started running and it popped down to a large rabbit hole. So did Alice. Alice also followed and she also jumped into the same rabbit hole. And the rabbit went down, the hole was very deep. And both of them fell down, deep down into that rabbit hole. Alice said aloud, "Where am I? How many miles down have I fallen? I must be getting somewhere near the center of the earth," she wondered. "Will I slip through the earth to the other side?" Thump! Alice landed on a pile of dry leaves. She looked around quickly and suddenly saw the white rabbit again. It disappeared, saying, "Oh, my ears and whiskers, how late it's getting." So when she fell, she was scared and she was talking to herself, thinking, she was asking many questions. Will I reach the other side of the earth? How far I have been falling into this pit and where will I reach? And she slipped through the earth and she's telling, will I slip to the other side of the earth? So she's thinking a lot and finally she fell on the dry leaves and she saw the rabbit again. And the rabbit was still murmuring. And what was he telling? It was telling that, "Oh, my whiskers and ears, how late it's getting." So we shall continue. Alice stood up and saw a small door about 15 inches high. It was too small for her to go through. So she saw a small door and it is very small that she cannot go through that. She saw a glass table with a golden key on it. And there was a table on which there was a key. She tried the little golden key in the lock and to her delight it fitted. Alice opened the door and looked into the loveliest garden she had ever seen. So the door was so small and she was not able to go out through that, but she was able to view the outer view through the door. And she saw a very beautiful garden that she has never seen before and she would ever see again. How she longed to be among those beds of bright flowers and those cool mountains. But she could not even get her head through the doorway. And the view was so pleasant and it was very beautiful that she wanted to lie on the bed of flowers. But what happened? The door was too small. She could only see. She could not put her head either through the door. "Oh, how I wish I could become smaller," she exclaimed loudly. So she said, "Oh, I wish I could become smaller, even smaller than this, so that I could pass through the door and visit the beautiful garden that I have never seen before." So that is the story. She is in a wonderland. She is imagining. She has reached a place where she saw a beautiful garden and she is not able to pass the doorway. So please read the story, try to understand. You will be having a class test. And before we wind up, I know you must have seen some movies related to the story. There is a very good story. It is produced by the Disney World and it is really wonderful. It will be good if you watch it. So that's all about the story today. Please read the chapter. We will meet in the next class. Thank you, children. Bye-bye. Have a good day.